joint for free. And kids in every neighborhood belong. It's the Bunyan Company, cause it's just for fun, you see. So come a running when you hear our song.
Come to order, come to order,
says the president. And when the Bunyan Company meets you, guess what we present?
Things to see.
And things to do.
Story.
Fun.
Toys.
All sorts of things of interest. And fun for girls and boys.
If you were to help me with my organ and grind the business of shrinking a violet, we could retire when you were 7 years old.
And I retire in about 3 days when I snatch that monkey and trade him.
My monkey! She's a gone!
Oh, mercy! I'll call the funny company detectives on my Jasper radio.
And so, funny company, this is the newest wrinkle in the space program. These baseball-sized satellites. If we can get 2,000 or 3,000 of these up in orbit around the Earth, they'd act as relays for a global television and radio network.
Golly!
And we want you to test the instrumentation, Jasper Park.
Well, thank you, sir.
Funny company, this is Shrinkin' Violet. Somebody just stole a monkey from Mr. Rossellini, and I think it was Billy Laguna.
Now we start with monkey business. I give you lessons on climbing up the second floor of Space Center and stealing one of those baseball satellites. Watch. You climb up, you tippy-toe the long edge. Monkey see, monkey do. You now see first human banana split.
Why would he steal a monkey to get into the Space Center?
Oh, they can be trained to do lots of things, even steal.
And for monkeys, or chimpanzees, why, space work is nothing new at all. The chimpanzee, or the chimp, as we in the science field call them, can do remarkable things with the proper training and patience. First, the chimp is trained to operate levers which cause a light to glow on an instrument panel.
Oh, I see. The chimp pushes the right-hand lever, and if he pushes it the correct number of times, that light goes on over to the left.
Right, Buzzer. Then the chimp is trained to turn that light off by pressing the lever on the left. All this time, the scientists are measuring his reactions, and they record the results for later evaluation.
Oh, doesn't that poor little monkey ever get hungry?
Very good question, Violet. And the food reward is the next step. When the chimp presses that lever the correct number of times, food is dropped into the tray on his left. The chimp has to repeat the same thing time and time again to get enough to eat.
He sure learns fast.
The next step is to train him to receive his food reward through a mouth tube. He playfully pounds the lever, and doing it correctly, he is fed through that tube. He soon learns that for a big meal, he must do it correctly many times.
Golly!
Patiently, the scientist fits him into his future space home, his space cockpit. He must be securely fastened in, but still be able to operate certain levers and be fed. Meanwhile, the scientists have many measuring devices wired into the chimp's spacesuit to make sure he's comfortable and in good physical condition. They check his pulse, temperature, blood pressure, and other things that will help our scientists make it safer for our astronauts in their space travel.
Okay, little Clyde, you go up to the second floor, look for a little black baseball satellite.
We'll catch Billy Laguna red-handed and put him in jail.
Here you are, fella. All the baseball satellites you want.
Only now, they've got cement in them.
You little monkey, throw down my satellite. All right, so I'm a bad catcher. I just wanted one.
Ow! Oh. Hey, you're so good a worker, Clyde. Get out!
And now it's time to go. We hope you liked our show. And we'll be back as quick as 1, 2, 3. And when we meet again, we hope you'll be here then. 'Cause now you